So you might be asking yourself, what exactly is geofencing? Our Roger Riley's been looking into this. He joins us live from Ames. And Roger, this could be the first time a lot of us are hearing this term, geofencing.
Yeah, it's a new one for me too, Janae. I grew up on a farm building fences to keep animals in check, but this one is one that is built online around a very specific area in the online marketing industry. It's a way to reach customers when they're nearby. Today I spoke with Benjamin Buslog and his company AdCelerant. Now, he's an Urbandale native who demonstrated for me how to make a geofence around his favorite hangout in Urbandale, Bebop's.
Geofencing is when somebody goes down and they target anybody who's been in this location. I can draw, it's, you know, sometimes geofences can be a radius. So you put like a center point and then it's just a radius. So you want to do a 50 meter radius, 100 meter radius, something like that. Or you can draw a polygon like this. I can actually draw a polygon here. And then anytime a person's in there, you can deliver an ad to them, but they have to be using their phone and it's not a pop-up ad.
Now, the ad would come up in your feeds on your various apps. He said he could even draw a geofence around Jack Trice Stadium or as small as the Global Cafe inside Curtis Hall. Ads could be sent to people who've been there at least in the last 12 months, even though they're not on site right now. And the geofence cannot personally ID people, but it can reap a lot of information about what is going on inside that geofence. His advice is to remember what is done on your phone is data that stays around. He calls it a little creepy.
So I like using that adjective because a lot of people think, you know, that's crazy. I thought the government can only do these types of things. Well, you know, when you have, you know, civilians able to take advantage of certain capabilities like targeting a device that somebody owns, totally anonymized. I can't sit here and say it's Ben's device or Roger's device. But when you can see that I can pull certain information about the users, it makes it pretty creepy.
Now, AdCelerant has the expertise. They use it for marketing, but you could see how law enforcement could use something like this. And the geofence area can also go as small as the front seat of one vehicle, just a very small area they can geofence that as well. So very interesting, something I didn't know about, and we're hearing more about it now.
Yeah, hearing from the experts, interesting but creepy. Interesting way to describe geofencing for sure. Thanks, Roger. Yeah.